Now that we have created this waterfall listings page using views, let's use views to also add a block of waterfall listings. To do that, go back to the waterfall listings view. I have it open in the other tab, but in case you need to get to it again, just visit structure and then views and then find the waterfall listing. Currently, we only have one page display on this waterfall listing view. We are going to add a block display to the waterfall listing. So next to waterfall listing, click on edit, which brings us to the page that we created. And what we are going to do is we are going to add a block display to this waterfall listing view. So under the displays section of views, click on the add button. Notice the various types of views displays that you can add right out of the box with views. There's attachment, which means you can attach it to another view. There's block, there's an embed, an entity reference, a feed, and we've already added a page. Again, other contributed modules such as display suite will allow you to create additional views displays. But for us in this course, we're only focused on page and block because they're a good representation of the other types of displays. So, when you're ready, click on Add Block. And the first thing that we're going to do, now that we've added this block display to the waterfall listing view, is let's change the block title. So under the title section, click on title, waterfall listing. We certainly could keep it as this, but I'm going to change it to recently added waterfalls. A very important step here to pay attention to is this for block. Instead of updating the title for all the displays on this view, such as the page, we only want to change the title to this block. So under the for dropdown, select this block override, which means the block title is now going to be recently added waterfalls, and the page display is not going to have its title updated. So this block override, recently added waterfalls is the new title. Click apply this display. Fantastic. Now, if we look under fields, it says the selected style or row format does not use fields. Again, if we go down just a little bit further to the preview, we see that it's listing our waterfall content exactly the same way as it was with the page. So in order to change this from showing content to showing fields, under the format section here, click on show and then click on the content link. And here, we're going to change it from content to fields. Now, again, pay attention to the for up here. We need to say we want to display fields for this block. We do not want to update all displays, which again would change the page display we already have created. So this block override, we're going to show fields, click apply this display. Now we have row style options. I'm going to keep the defaults for now, so click apply. And by default, the field that is provided is the content title, which is what we want. So if we scroll down to the preview, you'll see that, you know, it's listing the titles of our waterfalls. The other field I want to add is the location of the waterfall. So let's do that. Under the field section, click on add. And again, change for all displays to this block. We do not want to update the other page display that we've already created. Now search for location. So here, after I typed in location in the search bar, the waterfall location showed up, put a check mark next to it. It looks like this waterfall location is on content and it appears in the waterfall content type. This is what we want. So click apply this display. Now take a moment to examine these defaults. We have the ability to create a label if we wish. We can exclude this for display. This is for complex views. The formatter has various options, and I'm going to keep the default of label, which is basically the title. Now, do we want to link the location to its taxonomy term? We do not, so let's uncheck this link label to the referenced entity. That would actually link it to the taxonomy term. We do not want to do that. Now, there's various style settings you can check out. Again, we're not going to touch on any of these in this course. We could rewrite the results of this field if we wanted to, needed to. No results. We'd put the text in here. Administrative title. I'm just going to keep the default. Now apply this display. So far, we've updated this block display on the waterfall listing view to show fields. And currently, the two fields we are showing are title and the waterfall location. We haven't changed filter criteria. And we have not changed sort criteria. We will in a moment. Now that we look at our updated preview, we have a link to the waterfall by its title and its location. So far, so good. One thing I do want to change, because the name of this title is recently added waterfalls, is let's change the sort criteria from title to actually when it was last updated or created. So click on the Add button to add a new sort criteria. Again, change the four from all displays to this block. We do not want to change the sort criteria on the other waterfall listing page. For search, I'm going to look for created or authored on. We want to be sure to choose the category, not the content revision. We're not worried about revisions. We do want to select the authored on. The time that the node was created. There might be an update too. Let's search for that. Update. Updated comment. There is updated, but the category is comment statistics. We're not concerned with comments for waterfall listing. So go back to created. And I'm going to select authored on. Apply this display. And let's sort from ascending. Let's change the order to sort descending, which will give us the most recent first. Apply to this display. Fantastic. So right now we have two sort criteria. We're sorting first by title ascending, and then the authored on we're sorting descending. Now it looks like it doesn't change our list much, and that's because it's controlling the sort. So we need to remove that. One way to remove that is to click on the content title itself and then click on remove. Another way to do that is if you go to the add button, click the drop down and click rearrange, you'll see that we could rearrange and we could put authored on above or before content title. We could do that, which rearranges it. Or, again, I'm just going to completely remove content title sort. So click on content title and then remove. Make sure to click save. So we have updated the block display of the waterfall listing view. If we scroll down to our preview, we'll see that views is displaying the title and location of each waterfall. But the format this display is in an unformatted list. And it would look a lot nicer if we changed it to a table view. So to do that, scroll back up to the top. Again, in the block display, in the format section, under format, click on unformatted list and change it from unformatted list to a table. Once you've done that, click apply this display. The style options for the table are going to show up. And if we wanted to, we could display the waterfall location in the same table column as the title. We would do that by selecting column of the waterfall location, changing it to title. Personally, I think it looks better if we keep it in separate columns. So keep the defaults. Be sure to examine each one of these other options here. Most of them are self-explanatory. Click apply. If we scroll down to the preview, we'll now see that Dawson Falls and its location are on separate columns of the same row of the table. So this looks really nice. Be sure to click save if you have any unsaved changes. And now we have created a waterfall listing block. The next step is to place this block in a region. So to do that, I'm going to open up in a new tab, Structure Block Layout. Open Block Layout in a new tab. And let's place our recently added waterfalls block to the sidebar region. So scroll down to the sidebar region and click on Place Block. And let's filter for waterfall. And we see our waterfall listing page. You can see the category itself is views. It's a list. Click Place Block. Keep the defaults. We are going to display the title. Again, for reference, the title that we had set on the view is recently added waterfalls. So this is the title of the block right here. Let's go back to Block Layout tab. The items per block, let's just keep the default of 10. And if you want to, feel free to explore and change any of these visibility rules. I am going to keep the default and display on every page. The region is going to be a sidebar. Save block. And the final step is I want to display the waterfall listing, the recently added waterfalls, first and foremost. So I'm going to drag the block to the top of the sidebar and then scroll down to this page, save blocks. Okay, so at this point, we have created a block using views. We've added the views block to the block layout page in the sidebar region. So now if we go back to the waterfall listing page, and if we refresh, we're expecting to see a new block above this welcome block. So here we go. Reload this page. Here's our list of recently added waterfalls. Well done. In the next video, let's make this waterfall listing page view dynamic to be searchable by hike difficulty and by island location. See you soon.